I want to ask a slightly more personal question. A number of people asked me to ask you this, and we talked about it in advance. When we were together, I knew you always to be professional, serious, low-key, steely, which is a very good and important quality of people that. But never someone to call attention to herself. And then suddenly last fall, this is a big understatement, the spotlight is on you. Do you mind sharing with us, what did that feel like?
Well, it was in some ways surprising, certainly unwelcome, and not anything that I ever would have chosen for myself. I don't think anybody would have. But I think that when you find yourself in a position like that, and that's obviously a dramatic position, but I would say that over many years working for the American people and for the U.S. government, you have challenges, and so you have to you have to meet them in the best way that you possibly can, and that's what I try to do. And I you know, many people have, as you have sort of complimented me on that. I know that the State Department and the federal government, and I'm sure local and state government, are full of people who would have responded just as I did, just as the other witnesses did, that you are called upon to tell the truth. We are government officials, and so we respond in a non-partisan way. But it is important to tell the truth and then to hand it over to political leaders who take their own actions on that. I guess I would just say one other thing, which is that people have asked me, well, how did you know what to do? And I didn't. but I, there are little, these are not the most sophisticated ways of dealing probably with this kind of question, but there's two things. I thought about mentors I've had in my life, and I thought about my own mother, who is probably my first and most important mentor and the person I admire most in the world. And what would they do? And what would they want me to do? And how would they go about it? I mean, I think that sometimes asking yourselves questions like that can really find your courage. And the other question is perhaps a little less idealistic, but if in philosophy courses it's called the New York Times test. If there's going to be a headline in the New York Times, what do you want it to say about you? and so I found myself asking that question: how did I want others who have no dog in the fight at all to think about this? And so those were important ways that I kind of found my role with this.
Thank you.